We continue our conversation now with Peter Rohrman, Libertarian candidate for governor. It was Gary Johnson, when he ran as Libertarian for president, was famous as saying, I'm fiscally conservative and socially, I don't care. Or socially, I don't
socially
give a damn.
Socially tolerant, I think.
Yeah. He had a great saying, whatever it was. And you talked about that message a moment ago in your own words. How does that message translate to New Jersey politics and running for governor?
Well, my entire platform, when it comes towards the issues, everything I'm addressing is going to be used, we're using a libertarian-based platform. Now, we address things like legalization of marijuana. Okay, this is popular. People want this legalized. People in New Jersey are also starved for, when it comes to taxes, they want their taxes reduced. I'm producing or plans for, to reduce taxes, to legalize marijuana. Also, we're also introducing plans to help people defend themselves. We could talk about the instance of how Carol Bone, for instance. Carol Bone, I don't know if you know who she was. She was a woman that lived in Berlin, New Jersey. She was going through an abusive relationship, and she does what all women do in those situations. She goes out and she swears out a restraining order. You and I both know a restraining order, all it does, it doesn't protect a woman. It protects a judge's position. That's it. Now, she knew this man was going to harm her. What does she do? She goes out and she tries to legally acquire a firearm. So she goes through the process, goes to the police department, puts in her paperwork. Now, by law, by state statute, the chief of police in her town has 30 days to return that investigation as positive or negative. Well, there's no stipulations in the state law that say that they have to do it in 30 days, just that there's no penalty involved. So a lot of police chiefs, they kind of like string along. Oh, you're a woman. They just string along those applications for women for like 6-9 months till the woman gives up. Well, this woman was at near 30 days over the deadline. And who shows up at her house but her estranged lover, and he stabs her to death in her own driveway with her child. Hold on. So what I propose on doing is applying more libertarian answers to these problems. I am for.
You gave that a specific example.
Right.
How, as governor, do you solve that specifically?
If I'm elected governor of New Jersey, the first thing I'm going to do on Inauguration Day is I'm going to be handing out mass pardons proactively and retroactively to get rid of most of the New Jersey gun laws.
We know that for a fact. She did want that option?
Okay.
I want to get to other topics as well. So when I asked you about issues, you started with legalization of marijuana for recreational use, right?
No, not just recreational use. Also for medicinal purposes. I know plenty of people that are going through problems like their last term of life, and they want to go and administer marijuana to themselves for whatever reason.
I get that, but if you were to legalize it for recreational use, you could use it medicinally as well. So do you want it for recreational use, yes?
I've never smoked it in my life, have no intention to, but let's say I get racked up in a car accident and I'm living in pain the rest of my life, I personally would probably medicate myself with marijuana opposed to highly addicted opioids. Yes, I'm all for the legalization, untaxed, and having free of permits from the government to grow it.
And the third thing you talked about was taxes. You're in favor of a flat tax?
Yes, okay, I'm glad you picked it up. My tax plan, it's more than a tax plan, it's an overhaul of government. Right now, if you're a resident of New Jersey, the average person in New Jersey, they're spending 30% of their income to the state, county, municipal government. That's your income tax, your property tax, your sales tax, vehicle registration fees, everything you pay to the government outside of fines, is approximately 30% of your income for the average family. What I'm proposing is to limit that to 10% statewide with the added bonus of what I call fiscal democracy. Fiscal democracy is a plan of action that I've come up with to create a fourth branch of government where we strip away legislators' ability to appropriate at every single level, from the state, county, municipal level, strip away their ability to appropriate because they have proven beyond a shadow of a doubt legislators at every level cannot appropriate. Move appropriations into the hands of the individual so like you and I can decide what's good. So when a legislator
that would take a constitutional amendment.
Yes,
right?
It would. New Jersey State constitutional amendment. It would have to be that.
So you'd have to put that on the ballot and people would have to either
yes.
Vote yay or nay on that. So you'd be in favor of doing that. One last thing, and one thing you didn't mention, you're talking about a flat tax of 10%, which would conceivably be, and I'm sure you may argue with this, conceivably be a reduction in revenue. Bonds have been lowered once again by Moody's, and our bond rating's been lowered once again. And they talk about the pension problem and the fact that we are not funding our pension and we have no solution for the future when it comes to pensions. You do?
I do. My plan...
And talk about that in relation to your tax plan.
My plan, it actually addresses the pension problem on accident, okay? how it works, under my plan, you get to decide where to put your money in. Now, there are over 200,000 full-time equivalent employees in the state of New Jersey. That's state, county, municipal government. That's not just them. That's their adult children. That's their spouses. That's people in their community. That number quickly blossoms up to about 500,000 people. Now, those people are people, too. They get to decide what to do with their contributions under my plan. Where are they going to put it into? They're going to put it into your pension plan. See, under my plan, I've discovered there's two places that get overfunded first. The two places that get overfunded first are local school districts, believe it or not, and then the pension system. So under my plan, you need to put a cap annually of how much money can go in there a year. So that way, anybody makes a contribution after that, it gets kicked back and goes somewhere
else. And for the schools, that would be district to district.
District to district. Okay, but when it comes to school, I'm an advocate of what's called school choice programs, and specifically, voucher programs. Okay, right now we have a very limited amount of options when it comes to school choice. We have charter programs. There's some in Newark here, there. They're spread all over the state. And a lot of them, some do well, some don't. I'm advocating for voucher programs. Now, how these programs work is that you, instead of like your local school district will close down, they issue checks for $10,000, $12,000 to each child. And that child can then use that check to go to neighboring public school districts per diem, or the more talented children can use that money to go towards a higher-end private school, or you can use it for home study if you want. Now, that school that just closed down, that doesn't have to close down forever. You can lease that building out to whoever was interested to and run it for as a private school there.
And with that, I'm going to have to end. I think you got the point out. Thank you so much. I appreciate you being here. Peter Rohrman, Libertarian candidate for governor of New Jersey. When we come back. Still to come, school children in Newark receive the gift of music from a popular TV network. That's when Jersey Matters continues.